Hello, 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 and welcome to today's stream of the HCA. I'm just a little bit tired right now because it's pretty early for me in the morning, because we're gonna see a match between Garry's Buzzsaws and The Circle. And as you guys know, Garry's Buzzsaws are the Australian slash New Zealand guys, so that's why we are so early in the morning in Europe. And I even had this information from The Circle that I don't even have the right setup of people because everybody is still sleeping. So yeah, we're gonna play on Sainte-Marie-de-Mont, as you guys can see. And sadly, I'm alone, so you guys just need to listen to my creepy, weird English voice. So Kieran is not here. I'm very sad. I miss him really, so he will be there around like in the next game. Because I'm also going to stream 32 AD against Alpha. Going to happen later this day. And yeah. I'm pretty much excited sitting here now with my coffee. I think they're going for a knife party here right now. Just take a look. Good old knifing, I would say, yeah. But it looks like the Circle Boys are losing the knife fight.
Yes, we win. Easy. Charge him.
It's only Mr. Sane against everybody. I think the US servers are doing his great job. Oh, he got killed, he got slaughtered there.
Yes, boy.
Get off my mate!
Gangbang! This is right to be fucking brave!
Oh! Ruffy's going in for the kills. He's
boys,
the last man
so.
What am I seeing you right now in this body? The circle is getting pushed back here. As you guys can see, the match already started. We are playing on the AA network.
In the field already, ahead of us. There they come, boys. Gobble the fucker.
Oh man, that's why I love like the international communities like the Circle or even the Gary's Bushers. They wrote like in this channel when we meet up before that they want to meet up and do a knife fight, and it's just so good and so funny to see that it's just working correctly and everybody's just going in for the knives and nobody's trolling. Both of them traded there. But yeah, I think Gary's Busters are just like in the upper hand with the old Australian big knife against the UK knives here. Like the shovels, I would say.
I can't kill him, he's a ninja. Even the legs.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. In my body. Three enemy.
Save us, Suda. Show him what England's really like, boys.
Leave me like a few seconds. Just I'm like a little bit speechless right now. It's just too It's just funny to just watch them enjoy their life. Dead inside already. Oh. I wish sometimes you can hear like the enemy voice line too, if you do the local. Gets kinked up there.
Oh, that's racist.
Fucking hell.
Und so, and there it comes, the map flip. We have like these three hard caps. We have sorry for the English viewers. I just too stupid. I didn't change the game.
Tell me, have a good game. I miss you.
Yeah, I love you. Can you like rough you?
Tony.
I have like the German names on it, like Hugo's Hof, Netzwerk. At least I tried to call them in English. I'm sorry, I forgot to change the game's language into English. And my brain also needs like to change the language from German into English, so. So we got AA network. It's like we have the same setup again. And I need to look. Where is my dude? I need to join. My artillery boy. There he is. So yeah, we're playing on Barn, Rudy Lagar, AA network. Choose irgendwas. So yeah. Okay, and I'm going to switch the cam to the in-game. Okay, gonna make the music a little bit low. I think that should fix it up. I hope you guys brought out some good old coffee or tea or something else to drink, or just maybe you guys also woke up in a European and just prepare your breakfast and just take a chill and watch the game. It's going to be interesting because of the cap layout we have, like this weird snake. And AA network always a disadvantage for the allies, so I'm excited to see how the circle is going to play AA network out. Because it's always Axel's favorite. Yeah. Let me just gonna wait around the 1 minute. Gonna take a look. I just need like to do the audios. And yeah, we can take a look where the Axis players are. There we have Puma and Truck. We also got this transport truck, Panzer IV. Yeah. They're making a good setup, even like the Circle Boys, just with the setup. They have two Stuarts, one medium, one recon tank. They're also building like an anti-tank gun. I don't know what they are up to, but as a ground, I can tell you they are on the right spot to do some weird stuff. So they are prepared for something, so that's gonna be funny. So here we go. It's, I think, like the second HCA match. Is it? I think it is. In the minors, at least. And we can also hear like the truck sniping, holy shit. They even tried to get some trucks, but I don't think they got anyone right now. We have still the supply truck, the transport truck here, another transport truck there, and we have like on top here, the next transport truck. We have four transport trucks coming up from Garry's Busters. There even comes a rocket snipe, it was a close one. Aiming for the gap. circle. Everybody just jumping up. We have two MGs going up the roof. We have the steward pushing it down to the connector stuff here. We have the artillery going down on the transport truck. Another transport truck coming through. Just got killed by rocket. Straving run. A lot of stuff is happening around. We have one truck here. I think just completely got destroyed by the locks right here. We have so many explosions. Holy shit, what's going on here? Was it a transport truck? Yeah, it was. Yeah, but we have like zero guys here in this setup, in this building, in this where are the guys from the circle? I think they got killed in the truck. We have the Panzer IV coming up. We have a lot of pressure from the circle on this sector here. It's like they're playing opposite, like Garry's Bosses is here and the circle are here, so they're going down with the kills. Flo and Toast got killed there. You have Subsnore. Just aiming down, he's going for the kill for the transport truck. But got killed in the end. Garry's Bosses try to get into the hard cap, but they are still not even close there. I mean, the MG is sitting inside the hard cap, but there are no tanks inside the hard cap. It's sitting here waiting till the Lux shows up. We got one Lux up in the north sector, just got one rocket I think inside of it, and the midcap goes to the circle. So let's see, we got the Panzer IV. See, aiming for the medium tank. The medium tank is down here, so yeah, they're trying to get into the fight with the medium. But maybe he's just starts shooting infantry now because, yeah, the German got one hit in it, so the NAT repair. Now this is going to be interesting, because if you play like this cap layout now, you just need to get control up here, get control up here, and then you just try to start attacking the next cap. But as you can see, they still have no control about this compound here. Forward now, and the steward just got destroyed. Just got completely wrecked. I don't know by what, but maybe the rockets. And that's why the Lux is moving up now and doing pressure to the enemy infantry. We have still the medium down here. He's trying to get a new push on now. Going down, moving down those guys in the trenches, moving up slowly. Maybe one rocket guy. We have Maxwell coming up with the rocket. He aims too high, and the Lux just destroyed the OP behind the steward frag. So let's take a look to the Panzer IV again. And as infantry from Garry's Bosses trying to get into the hard cap with the support of the Panzer IV. And we can see the medium from the circles trying to peek again. Got some nice little peek there. But yeah, the Circle are really stomping in the north, in the east side sector here. They are strolling in the west. Because Gary's Busters are playing with more power here, because the next cap is obvious here in the back line, so that's why they're doing a lot of pressure in the west sector. We have Toes in the trench. Just suddenly Spanish drops. Oh, Toes, you know, behind Giddy. Giddy. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing your names wrong. Oh, but he doesn't know that he got shot from behind, but no. I think the US server makes this work. And Ozuna doesn't even know that Toes is an hard cap. Now this is dangerous for the Circle, because Gary's Busters are just moving up, getting control over the hard cap. Big spawn wave coming up there in north and the east side garrison there. We have the medium coming up right now. The looks got destroyed. I think the Panzer IV is now moving to the compound 2 to move up the road. Yeah, he is. And good flares here by their axes. Just spotting the medium. And Arnie is falling bad with his crew. And we have tank, Panzer IV from Aviator, but he can't see nothing. You can only see like this little people, this right, he gets headshot by his own tank. But in the meantime, like, the Circle is getting controlled back. Not the hardcap. Because of the Panzer IV, just changed his position from this side to this side. And I think if you are standing where he was before, you little bit dip into the hard cap, so they lost a little bit control about that. We have still a looks in the upper sector here, and the little forest here, and there is the first Tiger. There he is. And where's the first 76 coming up? He's in the back, he's also pushing up now. And what just happened here? Huh? Maybe he got, yeah, he got destroyed by the 76, I would say. Like, from this range. Yeah. So the 76 is taking it down, the Panzer IV. And now we have a medium and the 76 off the side from the Circle. So they're trying to get a lot of pressure. They're going for this peek around here to make a push to open to the next cap. Even the commander is setting up garrisons now. But still, there's like not that big control about this sector here. And that's why Gary's Busters are capping again. Sector here in this compound, we have Mr. Sane going up with his OP, we have Raffi. Ooh. Nice. Mr. Sane just in the wrong direction. Mirayon killing those guys with his MI's carabine. It's not my favorite weapon, to be honest. A lot of spraying is going down now. Playing on US server, only playing automatic rifles. Here, this is the looks coming from the little forest. The tiger is also pushing up now. He's making a move to the hard cap, but he's completely alone. He got no infantry support, but at least one MG, and the squad behind him is just spawned in, so I take that one back. What's going on now here on this mountain? We have one anti-tank gun here. What are they shooting at? Okay, they wait until the... Ah, the 76 is dipping up here in this sector, so yeah. It's a good anti-tank gun to annoy the tankers. But also the tiger now is getting pushed back because he's scared of the smokes. Never know what's going to happen if they're dropping smokes in front of you. Ooh. Instantly get taken down by the driver's MG. Oh no, by the gunner's MG. The anti-tank gun just got destroyed there. And now the 76 can make some moves. We still have the medium tank. Where is he shooting at? Okay, just hitting and hitting and hitting with the HE shells. The tiger just making up a move now. Can follow him a bit. Because I think he wants to fight the 76. There's also coming up a Stuart this road, and another 76 just got... I think that's the driver from Arnie's tank, that's why Arnie's just sitting here, spamming his shells into the cap. Now the tiger's coming up. I think in this position you cannot see the 76. Busty tries to get and make some move into the road, but yeah, the Stuart just pushing by. Uh oh. And what is the Stuart up to? Oh, I think he's going to get a lot of pain into his buildings there. If he gets that far and not killed by the tiger. Nice try there from Chef. Now the Stuart's just pushing and maybe taking down some OPs here. Maybe that's the main reason why he's pushing down there. And the Tiger turns around to try to take a shot, and the next rocket misses the target, and the Stuart just pushing by. Oh, gets destroyed by the Tiger. Nice shot there from Licky. The 76 is also damaged. To go back, just got shot in the front. Maybe he got hit by the tiger, and that's why the tiger is pushing up. Maybe it's a second tiger somewhere. Maybe up here in this sector? No. Somewhere there's a second tiger coming up. Gravity is trying to get to the 76 to repair it, but still, Circle got a strong hand on the AA network. I wonder how Tozy just every single time he just moves up here into these trenches. Like, how can he do that? Like... Oh, now he's got taken down by... Oof. I'm like too stupid to call this name. But yeah, overall, as the time flows by, the circle gets nearly more control, and they start to get control even here. They make the moves down here, and looks good for the circle right now. Man, I think that's like the hell of a dream for every single infantry player playing this side here. It's like a lot of pain. Nearly knifed Gravity there, but Gravity just got covered by the MG. But now the tank shape is coming up, the next anti-tank gun is there. As you can see, there's the little cemetery, I would say. With all these tank anti-tank guns, the Tiger now moving up. And I think, yeah, but I think it just got marked there because of the flares, nice flares there from the circle. But also on the enemy side, they're dropping flares on the tanks. We have the next 76 coming up to the main slide here. The two Tigers are stacking up. Next tire is going to get shot by the 76. Interesting battle. No! The Tiger just stops and I think he's taking the first shot. Yeah, he hits the first shot and now the second Tiger makes his moves. Oh, he shot! And the second 76 showing up, and now the Tiger is kinda... Oh, he missed the shot. And the first Tiger dies. And now they have 276 against one Tiger. That was well played there by Circle, just moving up his tank up the mountain and just surprised another Tiger. Ooh. And even a precision strike is coming in, but it hits nothing. Oh, but how the circle? Just, I think he just threw down the satchel here somewhere. Or maybe he doesn't. Maybe he did, I don't know. Got the anti-tank gun just hitting on the 76. Oh, what was that? Yeah, there is the anti-tank gun. But why did I stop shooting? Why is he only alone on this gun? Well, that's a little bit miscommunicated here. Panzer 4 and the 76 making a big move here. In the meantime, the circle tries to set up the attack to the next point. Yeah, nice smokes there by Ketos. Just smoking on the tank so the tank can see shit. I would shit my pants if I were this tiger right now. Like, my mate just got destroyed, what should I do now? Fall back? Like 276 on the same position trying to make the encounter on me? But yeah, the smoke just delays the attack from this from the 76. Like, by a lot. But Gary's boss's infantry just baking moves, trying to get back into the cap. Through the mid, through the mid grind. And everybody, don't forget, stay hydrated. Take a sip of your tea, a coffee, or what else you have. So now what? The 176 got damage. I think it's track damage, but I'm not sure. But we have the Tiger trying to get the shots connected into the 76. Hit in the tracks? I think he got hit in the tracks. I need to sneeze. I'm sorry guys, I just died like for a few seconds. Yeah, the Tiger's making up the move now. The 176 just drifting and doing like Tony Hawk style here. Like want to get some style points. It looks so ridiculous. Now gravity is coming back again, the tank energy. But yo, oi guys, you need some repair? takes his flame torch out now. But where's the Tiger right now? Tiger's right there. Sorry for this hectic maneuvers of the camera. Oh, another Tiger? No, it's again an anti-tank gun. Like, we don't see that much here. And he's just peeking and trying to annoy the 76 again by his moves. The 76 getting another peek. Oh, but the anti-tank gun just shot his bullet into the hedge row. Another rocket coming in there, nice rocket. Ooh, nice shot there by the tanker. By Desert Fox. Now the tank driver jumps out to repair the tank. The Tiger's making his move. Big problem right now here is if you have track damage, the first thing they will do is just repair the tracks. So the Tiger has the upper hand right now. Ooh! And he destroys the 76. Now he's going back, even though the 76 hit the first shot. Was totally damaged and prepared by the infantry. Great work here by Gary's Bostos. Ooh, but now driving back into the silo is like... when the artillery is sitting down on you. Oh, guys. Another rocket tries to hit the... there. Infantry of Gary's bosses. Trolling around with the rockets. even a supply truck coming up here, putting more supplies down here to build up more anti-tank guns. Like this graveyard here. And they're going in again into... They have like only the one mission to destroy a tank with an anti-tank gun. It's so good to see like guys so committed, and now Battletoads coming up here.
Yeah, you got lots of infantry running too.
Oh, got one hit there by the anti-tank gun, and the anti-tank gun tries to get another shot, and he hits another shot. Maybe this tiger is pushing up. And finally it makes works. The two heroes, the anti-tank gun heroes, just destroyed 176. Good job there by Gary's Busters. And now they have like 176 moving up again, and nothing more. They have only... Oh, never mind. They still have 176 near half cap, but... He also needs to repair. I think he's fighting against a second tiger. Like here somewhere is the Panzer IV. There he is. He's pushing forward to the cap, and we have one tiger up here. And it's like always the same. If you're streaming a game, you think like, okay, maybe we talk like already 60 minutes and it was like only a half hour now playing on this game, so we still have like 1 hour up to, and that already happened so much. The close quarter infantry fights here near the hard cap. Toast there again with this, with his bazooka. Ooh. Now the infantry is trying to storm this Panzer IV. But got completely annihilated by their MG and tank NG. Is fighting against the tiger. Oh, nice shot there. But I think it's just hit the turret. Let's take it up. No, it was a whole shot. Nice shot there by the tanker. Really great shot there by AMS name. And I enjoy it like. Always need the tanks, they're running around engines with shotguns. Of the second tiger up the road here on this crossroad. He just got marked, I think he just got, yeah, he just got discovered there by the artillery, the recon plane. Gary's boss has started capping because of the pressure of the whole tanks. I think the Panzer IV, yeah, it is, it's inside the hardcap. As you can see, there's something wild going to happen for the Panzer IV. On 76 now, trying to get an aim on this, what? As you guys can hear, the bombing run is coming down. Not hitting that much, I think even just destroyed the tracks of the Panzer IV. Maybe even more, but I'm not sure. Eddie just jumps out and tries to repair with his torch. Now you just realize, okay, the artillery is coming down here. Maybe I should jump in again. Ooh, what was that for a ricochet? Another ricochet. And the tiger just got one-handed again. moving back. It's so difficult to hit them there, because you can only see the turret of the 76. Toe Snow with his rocket. If he knows what's behind this. And now they're placing a satchel here. Maybe he gets a kill on the Panzer IV. The Tiger's coming up here too. He just had one hit in his soul. They're driving this 76. Ooh. But still, he has like he's damaged, he cannot push up. Holy fuck, what happened there? I think he's getting shot by another tank, and they're just completely annihilated the one tank. The two Tigers just working together, and the 76 is pushing up here. Ooh. That's not looking good for the Tiger right now. That's one turret shot in it. Tries to move back. The 76 got no vision on it again. So we only have again one 76 against two Tigers. Yeah, the next one just spawned up. But they need to drive it forward, and Gary's Buster's just taking huge control of, around the hardcap. Tiger now. Still damaged, but he's pushing up. He wants to support his infantry getting into this cap, but the circles start defending because of their reinforce on it, and with this a lot of infantry guys into the hard cap. The 176 just got destroyed. By what? What just happened with the 76 up top here? I don't know. I really don't know what happened there. But now we have like for a circle zero tanks and only infantry. That doesn't look so good for a circle. Just coming down for the axis. It's a really good placement there. If they get like a lot of spawns in there, they will surely cap a network. Let's take a look. I will snooze like this. And only like two guys just spawned again. Why do we even put up an air right there? If you just spawn two guys in. Like, bro. Just let your whole team spawn. Come on. Huge spawn wave near hardcap. Come on, guys. Another spawn wave comes in, but this time with three people. Pan just jumps out of his tank, the tank commander, starts repairing. It'd be so good if the NG would spawn in the air right now. But in the end, the Gary's Buster's just kept the AA network. Now a huge spawn wave is coming in. There's air in the air. We have like two MGs making their way to the hard cap. We have one MG got completely destroyed by artillery fire. But yet now it just changed, like the circle in the west sector and Gary's boss in the east sector. We have Yeet tries to get on with his satchel. He already got the satchel planted on this tiger. So goodbye Richie, goodbye Yuki, goodbye Oni. Was great work against the 76. But Yeet just yeeted the tank away, but now he's dead. Let's take a look in this compound right here. Ozuna on the roof taking down two guys. A lot of spawns on the circle coming into health control. We have Andolf there taking down two guys. We have Murray coming down with his BHR. It's taken down by Preppy. Preppy with another shot. Now Gravity on top of this tank. Nice positioning. Oof, this one. Ooh, oh! Gary's boss is just making huge progress through the midline. Just pushing forward. Box bitch coming up. All the circle just coming up. Oh, I got taken down by Mr. Sane there. So Mr. Sane covers his OP, but also Busty got his OP up here. So still two full swords can spawn in here in this sector. So Tiriri is trying to come. And now I hear the bombing run. Coming down for this hedge roll. Gary's boss has still got no 100% control about this connector, compound, crossroads, call it whatever you want. Every single team just pronounces it in another way. So Ozuna, they're completely destroying with the shotgun. Good dog gets headshot there. Box bitch coming up with this MG again. Both Bestie and Busty and Xavier just on the roof. Gravity still on his tank. But yeah, somehow the whole micron just disappeared from Gary's Busters. If I take like a look away from the signal, then all just died. But do we have like something else going on in the backside sector? No, there's nothing. So they try to get there. We have a few squad leads just running by. We have Puma here, just try to get there, but sadly with zero squad leads in it. Yeah. The tiger pushing up this mountain. As a player, I even don't like to play on NA West. It's like the rubber bending and the hit rack is just so stupid sometimes. Like in the game we played against the line, everybody in the infantry just had so big problem hitting someone. Xavier is the last man standing, but all OPs got destroyed. And now the circle needs to make another move, but I think the Puma just hit the hard cap. Or even, yeah, he just hit the soft cap. And that's what I mean, like, put two squad leads in it, and then you just drive there, put your OPs down, make a lot of pressure, and everybody in front needs to redeploy. Like, you have, like, zero control now, you don't know what happened around this here, because you don't have a garrison. Maybe the garrison just got destroyed by the Puma, that's what I suggest right now, because there are supplies. So the Puma just driving around, searching for hardcap garrisons. Yeet. Puma just making a lot of annoying progress here. So where are the tanks? We have 176 here, second 76 up front, mediums pushing down on the right sector. And now that's what I mean, if you have a network as allies and you lost it, it's so ridiculous stupid to push up this front here. You just move up open field, you can get destroyed by MGs from the left side. You get shot by MGs and by MGs from the right side somewhere. And then we have the tanks and artillery, and you mostly want to beat your PC up or your table. But yeah, 76. Oh, what? Oh, on Richie and his crew trolling Reese. That could have been worked out better, to be honest, but they just yeeted the Puma in there. Could have taken like a few shots from back there and then move. But we have the second 76 coming up. And I think the tiger on top there should see it. Pushes a few meters forward and he's making a move. Does he make a move? Nope. It just looked like a beard for the tiger behind the bush. But yeah, he got marked there at 276 now. Can make like a double peek on it. So, we still have 40 minutes on the clock. Let's see, yeah, we have like the MG set up for the Germans doing this one, and we have another bombing run coming in. I wonder where it goes. It kills like 3 people. Wasn't that effective for the investment of the ammunition? But who am I to judge? Like, I'm the worst one placing the bombing runs. And the 76 tries to shoot with both guns, just hits the tracks, and I think that's unfortunately... Oh! The lucky there by the tiger just got bounced by the shot, so they are still alive, and Surpus shooting his rockets about like 200 meters, 300 meters, and they're just hitting the target. There he is again. He wants to shoot another rocket. Our artillery is coming down here, so both of the crews are just only like the gunner and the driver. That's a huge disadvantage now. The 176 is moving away, there's coming Yeet and Reese. Oh, Reese just got drove over by his tank, unfortunately. And Reese also just got destroyed by infantry. Damn, that hurt my feelings. But where's like there's older repair stations up here. They're throwing down supplies here to get up repair stations for the 76. We have like a lot of engineers spawning in there. Three engines just putting down this repair station. That's what I mean, like, you should do the same with the Tiger up top here. Give him the support. Place the repair stations. Ooh, what was that? Another Tiger coming up there. And we have on this side, we have also a Tiger starting an attack on Rue de la Gare. But I think he's aiming for the 76 and now, ooh, sadly the one anti-tanker just got killed there. I just love how committed those Gary Buster guys are just running into the MG fire of the tank. Oh no. The Tiger just makes a sudden move and he has like a one second time window. But Roboto is coming up now and Tofu. Oh, he hits the first rocket and now Tofu's time to shine. Bling bling. Just hits the target but bounces it away like a few miles away. Now Tofu with a second shot. Ah, a little bit too high there. Huh? What? Was there a mine or something? Oh, and on precision strike on the Tiger up top here. Oh, it destroyed the repair station. I still don't know what happened here with this video tank. You guys need to answer this question. I don't know what happened there. So yeah. But now, Gary's boss is making a move with his infantry, pushing to the side where the repair station hub is and the 76? Ah, there it is. He's up top here. Change his position from the repair station hub to somewhere else. And this 176 getting a nice angle there on the Tiger. Ooh! Gets a hit in its turret. And he needs to move back. We have so from the side. Oh, we have two Tigers up here now. Two Tigers, no repair stations. The 76 there on the left side in the in the wheat field. He's pushing up through the hedgerow. We have a lot of infantry from Gary's Brushers on this side of the hedgerow to try to get control over the wheat grind. A lot of guys here up in this compound. In German we call it Rattenhof. So yeah, infantry making trading and try to do stuff. The two Tigers trying to get double peek there on the 76. At least one guy hit this target. And the 76 just hit the Tiger back. No, the second 76 is coming up. Are they both standing there? Yes, they're both standing there. It's... If I would do this peek now as a commander and I would see those tanks there just watching me, I would shit my pants, for sure. I would say, okay, that's it. I'm dead, man. Both of them are still trying to get a last shot on this 76. Oh, he just drove back to this snow. But he cannot see the tigers up there. It's not a good position to fight them. The repair torch is out again. So making progress there with his car 98. He even takes down Jonathan there. Gravity last one standing. Gets pushed there by Rustic. I feel like Gary's Buster's playing comforty, like playing on their NA West servers. As Australian and New Zealand guys. MGs up there, we have Dankus with his sniper rifle up the roof. The infantry is trying to get control here. So we have the 76 up here, 76 there, we have 376. I wonder where the third tiger was. I think he got destroyed. No, he's standing here. Aviator. Trying to protect his infantry. We have the one tiger. The second tiger? I don't know, it's too hard to see. Oh, he's making a push maybe through here? No. That would be a ballsy move now to push up here and do like a round about the 76s. Oh, he's up in the middle now. There he is. Destroyed 176. The Tigers I have having the upper hand right now. Oh, he's getting shot there, I think, from Shape's crew. And he's dead. Because he makes the move to the side. Oh no, never mind! The gunner there just hits the building, and now I think they are a little bit in cover. Yeah, they are in cover. But they need now the infantry support. I think they're just stopped and do repairing stuff now. Yeah. It's pretty dangerous to do this in an open field. Let's see what his crew is doing now. He's pushing up with the 76. Wants like to kill their. He wants to hunt down his prey. And now the Scotty is coming up. Is he knifing? He's going to knife. He's going to knife. Just a little drive-by knife. And now they're just sitting, the commander, without a driver. And now the next one is coming up with the shotgun, with the satchel. He got killed because he heard the OP in the wheat field. Oh, Another tiger just got hit by the 76. Ooh. Up there, you can see it a little bit. Both tigers are falling back. We got the third tiger up the mountain now. Everybody's just looking at the same tanks. Nice working together by the tigers here. They try to cover each other. We have Meat Artie just try to get to the tank back. What's this little roleplay here? Well, he got his OP and now this two guys, one Satchel dude with his shotgun and one rocket dude. This oh, he got taken down. One hit and oh, now there's kind of, this is a scary moment. They put a second hit on the 76, but the tiger just got destroyed there by Shape's crew. And now the tank just, not the next tiger just moving up, try to get an angle on it to take a revenge shot, but who was that? Who was that? I have no clue what happened to this time to the 76. Please, I don't know who was it. Was it the tiger up here? No, I had like a shot from this sector. I don't know who it was. The 76 got just re-peaked and killed. I have no clue. I don't know, guys. Let's go back into this. Maybe it was this tiger. And the next tiger coming up. Taking down the repair stations. Where are the 76? We have two inside spawns. And one steward coming up, but there's no much pressure against the tanks here. Only infantry is left to do the job. They're hitting the trucks. Now the steward is coming up. The steward has his advantage now because of the trucks are damaged. Maybe he gets like 2-3 shots in it. They're making like whoops. The tiger just turned around. The tiger gets so annoyed by the infantry. And he's putting up his satchel right now. But he kills the steward. Richie's going out. He tries to kill the guys in the pursuit. And there goes the tank. Completely destroyed by the infantry. With constantly hitting the tracks, annoying the tank. Pretty ballsy move there from the tiger, just pushing without infantry. We have Baker, we have the guy who just robbed through the fields, has his OP up here, we have Easy OP up here, they can start making a check move. We have 25 minutes left till the match is over. The circle needs to get like a good attack, like the tanks should beat up. And wait, we only have medium 76, we can tank up. But we got one tiger destroyed, two tigers destroyed. Also, the Axis need to push up with new tanks. So yeah. Kinda even right now. Just unlucky how fast the game can change, like from having 3 tanks to have like 0 tanks. The circle is getting like control back about this compound. They're like I told before, they're pushing with his easy OP up here, coming up to this mountain and try to get to the connector. But they're just supplies. I thought they were gonna throw an air or something. Pretty tough fights in the hedgerows. Here we have the tanks coming. Wait, what's going on here? How is Lifty coming up here? He just satcheled the garrison back here. Okay. Gary's supposed to try to get control on the east side to get into Rue de la Gare atop here. We need to cap this one. We could get control about this sector and then just push here. And you need to go over cattle sheets. So. But they don't need to attack. They can just rest in peace and just chill out till the game is over. Because they are. 3-2-2, so just need to defend all the time. The circle needs to make a big move to take back AA network. And you can see, like, they're pushing through the midrun right now. We have Maripo, it's taken down by Flo from the side. But the circle try to get there by harsh fights. But if Mr. Sane taking down 2 guys there. I think he's pushing for the OP. Yes, he is. Takes on the OP, but I think there should no. There's no spawn wave coming in. He got the OP, so they can make a move now to the connector. Dangerous. The MG setting up. Cook it with his MG. Now he's getting. Time lock there. Tiger moving down the hill again. Mid boss is there also waiting for the allies coming up. No, he's pushing now. Text on Mr. Sane. But here we have the Spanish infantry corps coming up. Sorry. And this looks dangerous if all those players would move up the road, come up to this position where Mikit is at the moment. They would have a huge pressure into the hard cap. But now the artillery is going to aim this road. This is going to be awful painful. And also the Tiger is shooting down there. Gravity now. Misses his shots, gets taken down there. Yeah, and they're just closing the road with the tank shells and with the artillery shells. Uh, And now I hear like a next bombing run coming in. I think there's going to be from Gary's Buster just up the road, or maybe from the side of the road. Yeah, going down side the road. Would have been huge if it would be like this side or this side. Would have cleaned up so many kills there. Infantry totally gets smashed there. Tiger here on this hill. He's hurting so much. The next tiger on the right side of the map. I think he just taken down the whole cruise up here. And if I would believe, I think the Greyhound just. He just like. It's a little bit stuck there. Yeah, the tiger nor east side. And he has like no opponent. The circle tanks are just 176 coming up. And we have, I think we have like three tigers again. We have one tiger up here, we have a second tiger there. And the third one is, yeah, he's up this mountain. So we have three tigers against 176. The circle here, the circle stands in a real disadvantage. They even need to cap A network, one of the worst cap layout for allies. There should be happening some magic here, because we only have like 80 minutes left. So the infantry get completely wrecked by tanks and artillery fire, MGs and all this stuff. Yeah, but Gary's Busters are still pushing the circle back. Not even giving a little chance like here to have control about something. We can take a look on the scoreboard for a sec. Because I'm like totally interested, like the artillery already of what 800 points, we have one tank 2600 points. Yeah, it's not like that circle are the circle are trying at least with everything they got. But like I said before, it's really difficult to play on the server, like as a European. As you can see, like they're playing all with 200 MS or even more, or even higher. Even though the Australian or New Zealand guys have the same issue and the same problem, it's like a huge fuck up there. Got the Recon plane coming up. Probably be spotting now. The tiger on the hill, the second tiger here, but the third tiger is pushing up the road here without any tank trying to stop in there. Oh. Driving against the building. Now he's building up. Oh, there's also again an anti-tank gun. Maybe the anti-tank gun just had a big point for this matchup here. And I heard like precision strike. Try to kill the tiger on the hill here, but he's pushing away now. Maybe he's trying to make a move with the second tiger on the right side to get huge pressure on Rudolf Lager. As you can see, there's like not much of the infantry left here. They have still the garrison set up, but Garish Busters are still pushing. I can take a look what the 76 is up to. We have a one anti-tank gun on the side here. One Panzer crew without tank, they're just trying to make work now done with the anti-tank gun. They get a hit on the Tiger. Next hit on the Tiger. A third hit. But they're suddenly just stopped, and now the 76 is making another shot. That's really nice work there by the anti-tank gun and the Panzer crew. That's the can opener. One tank down, two to go. And now the infantry can make more moves here. And in the mid also, because the artillery is going down this sector now. And the one Tiger just moved away, so they stopped shelling at HE shells into this road. Maybe that's the can opener for the circle. Oh, they're baddie boy. That's a real baddie boy. Oh, aviator jumps out, you saw that. Nice, nice job there by the tank commander. Oh, this was also good that he had like his MP40. And the Roboter throwing now his yeet. But Overtuner just peeking by, sees the OP, oh, got taken down by the MG. Sound effects of those MGs. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Like 12, 11 minutes to be fair, but the circles start capping now because of the much soft cap pressure they have. Like in this sector, they have so many people in it now. And Garry's Busters suddenly have like zero infantry around here. Uh oh. Just soft cap pressure. Now the hard cap garrison had like a few spawns and now they're already deafening again. What the hell is going on there? Someone just yeeted away. There it comes, the airhead from the circle. Where is it going to land? It's going to land mid hard cap here. And the MG player is like looking upwards. setting up his MG. It's a weird airhead to be honest. Without control. Oh. He's doing a bombing run combo. And the airhead got destroyed. Nice play there by Garry's Busters. But maybe it was just too. How would I say it? In English alone. Just to fake it and to make everybody move into the hardcap so you get control here. But he's not much infantry left. It's like. You have only like two OPs up here. Nothing else in this mid-range sector or on the right flank. It's only making pressure to this here, and now the tigers are just shooting in there, and the artillery I think is going to move up there too. And then a really good death there by Gary's Buster with nice play. I'm not freaking out like getting an air hit or getting capped through soft cap. That seemed pretty calm because not that many people spawned in. Now they're making a lot of big move, closing these gaps here. Get near Rue de la Gare. Freaking plane coming up from the axis. Maybe I try to do stuff like throwing an air hit or maybe even starting attacking. But yeah. Chef! Oh! Ruffy just taking him down. But with the shovel. Nice job there. And Cactus is coming up now. He does know that Ruffy is still alive there. Everyone just passing by. Not much to see here, not much to see here. Only Ruffy chilling. Ruffy with the second one. Now the MG. Oh, we only got one hit. Oh, it's so sad. But nice job there from Ruffy. And one tiger? Was it a tiger or was it an anti-tank gun? It was a Stuart making a push here. Totally got destroyed. And 276 and one medium. Medium in the mid and the 276 in the flank. That's the last push, I think. The last things the circle can offer to try to cap AA network. The last minutes are trickling in. We have the two tigers ganging up here. The 76 just hit the tiger in the tracks or in the side. Get second shot in it. The one tiger is down. Good job there by the 76. Now the second tiger is coming in. Does he see the 76? I'm not quite sure. Maybe he does if he still waits. And there it shows up. Ooh, no, they're hitting off the brakes. Making like a big push, fourth gear, and now they're waiting. The 76 is coming up. There's this little time, this little peak window. Oh, takes his turn to the 12 o'clock, but 76 just passing by. They're both missing each other. I'm not quite sure if the 76 knows about the tiger, but sorry. Next window, but he does see. Oh, he doesn't see. The commander doesn't look the right way. And now I think he does know it. Just take a look to the left. Now he's shooting with his MG. Oh, that's not good. 76 knows. He puts his. Oh, this doesn't look good for the tiger. At least the 76 knows where the tiger is right now, as you can see. But now they're making a sudden move too. Tiger now? Ooh, they're dancing. And now they start firing at each other. Or not. Ooh. This is so unfortunately how the walls are underway. But Gary's bosses start capping. Andolf the White inside the hard cap. The 76 still fighting against the tiger. Fighting, I don't know if they call it so that way. Nobody shot, one shot, one bullet. Only the MGs to fight the enemy infantry off. But you driving into a... And that's unfortunately just getting hit by the second tiger there in the back. And the tiger's coming up. And they totally destroyed the 76 by nice teamwork. And there's only one 76 left on this side. And maybe Gary's bosses are trying to make a big push to cap the Rue de la Gare. The tiger's going in fourth gear. But the infantry just totally got killed behind the tiger. The tiger cannot wait for his infantry. The second tiger is coming up. If he touches the hard cap, if he kills the garrison here, garrison should be, yeah, is around under the corner here, where he's got an anti-tank mine there. Blocking the garrison, now the spawn wave is coming in, Arnie is there. He runs in a different direction. The greyhound is fighting the tiger, what's going on, man? Gets one shot in his ass. Shoots over the greyhound and they both start dancing with each other. Oh, and the greyhound destroys the tiger. But nice mines, the mine down here just carried so much. Took down the tank by half of his HP, so... But yeah, 30 seconds to go and then it's GG for Gary's Busters. Taking the win out of this first match in the HCA. It's a good start for Gary's Busters. Even though the Lux is coming up, yeah, that's totally GG. Nothing else the Circle can do right now. Oh. Another encounter, Tiger against 76. 76 got shot, I think, in the turret. No. 76 got destroyed there. But there's an anti-tank gun still in back. Yeah, and the last arrow is coming in, but yeah, nothing else that can do more. This one is GG. GG to both of the teams. And congratulations to Gary's Busters for their first win in this tournament. I hope it was at least nice to watch. It was a little bit entertaining. We had like a few funny moments, even in the beginning, like the knife fight. Everybody who just showed up like 20 minutes into the game, just watch the replay and just looked the first minutes before they flipped the server. So funny. The knife fight was so funny. Not even yet. Gary's boss just got inside Rue de la Gare with a lot of infantry. And even the second tiger is in there. So yeah. GG, ladies and gentlemen. And now we can take a look to the stats and can see who carried the most. We gonna take the pregame setup again. Yeah, just can take a look on the tanks. So we got decent points, good points. Infantry also a lot of points. We got the artillery guy, like a lot of points. Who can guess it? Yeah. But also on the other side, we have good tanker stats, good infantry stats. Really well played. So that's from my side of the sector. I was from my side of the POV. Yeah, that's called better. Later this day, like I think in already 2 hours, I'm going to stream again. There you guys can see the wait, give me a sec, I need to reorganize my English for a little bit. My tongue got stuck up. Okay. In 2 hours, there's going to be a second match between 22AD against Alpha. It's going to be an interesting game too. And later this day, like in the evening, we're gonna play against Refuse on Quarantan. And you guys can see my POV there too. Playing Tinker. Who can guess it? Yeah. Thank you for watching. Maybe we see you later. And if not, have a nice day, my friends. Goodbye. Bye bye. To the group.